In this video, I'll talk about concentration of solutions, or molarity of solutions. The question is, how many grams of sodium carbonate, Na2CO3, would be needed to make 355 milliliters of 0.250 molarity solution? The capital M stands for molarity. So right off the bat, let's talk about how we find molarity. And it's not that difficult. It's similar to density, actually, of a substance. And that is molarity, abbreviated capital M, equals the number of moles of the solute, and the solute in this case is going to be the sodium carbonate. So moles of the solute divided by the volume. So that's why I say it's similar to density. It is not density, but it's similar to that. So the volume, and the volume is going to be in liters. So liters of solution. Because when we talk about molarity, it is assumed that we're talking about a number of moles per liters of solution. Whereas density, you could talk about density per cubic inch or per cubic centimeter, and that can vary. But molarity always has this same definition. That's why I write liters rather than just the general volume. However, we can shorten this equation to just the capital M equals N. The small n is used to denote number of moles of something over, and I'll put V for volume, and then we know for molarity we're always going to be dealing with volume in liters. So let's get this out of the way. 355 milliliters, that equals 0.355 liters. Okay, so that's what we're going to use. So make sure you are in liters. Now, it asks for how many grams, but this equation doesn't find grams. So we're going to find number of moles of the sodium carbonate that we need and then convert that to grams. So anytime you're doing a molarity problem, you should be given two of these three things, and then you'll solve for the third. So this time we're given the molarity, that is 0.250. So I'll write 0.250 equals the number of moles is what we don't know, that's gram, and then we will convert that to grams. So I'll put just N here. The volume we do know, that's the 0.355 liters. So I'll write that for volume. And again, the volume is always in liters when you're dealing with molarity. Now, solving for N, you get N equals 0.08875. That's moles of Na2CO3. You might be saying, hey, we only have three significant digits. Yes, we do, but hold on to your decimal places until the end. And you can round it at the end of the problem. Let's convert this, or let's talk about how many grams are in this. What's the molecular mass of Na2CO3? Well, we've got two sodiums, so two times the molar mass of sodium, and that is 22.99, plus one carbon, so that's 12.01, plus three oxygens, so 3 times 16.00. Sum all of that up, and we get 105.81 grams per mole of the sodium carbonate. Now we'll just convert this, and what we have here is 0.08875 moles of the Na2CO3, and the proper conversion fraction that we're going to multiply by, we want to cancel out moles, so we'll put mole in the denominator, and for every one mole of sodium carbonate, we have 105.81 grams. So the moles will cancel and we'll be left with grams, just exactly what we wanted. So this equals, now I will round to three decimal places, 9.39 grams of the sodium carbonate, Na2CO3. So there's a nice example of molarity, or concentration of solutions. And as always, if you found this video helpful, consider liking it or sharing it with a friend.